You'll never get to make money trading Forex if you are not going to follow this method that I'm about to share with you. Trust me, I've been trading for more than 3 years and I've been consistent ever since 2018, so I know what I'm talking about. Well, just to clear something off my chest, to be honest, like, I get a lot of chats from traders out there asking me, why do you keep on doing these YouTube videos or these free trainings that you always be posting about? And it's because I love it. Like, at the same time, the most selfish thing that I can do is to help someone else, because when I help someone else, I feel better. I feel like I'm doing something with my life. So that's one of the most selfish things I can do, to be helping people out there. So I just wanted to clear that off for all those that have been asking questions. So in this video, we are actually going to be speaking about why most traders out there don't get to make money and how you actually, because I can't be speaking about the negative side of things, I'm also going to be diving onto the positive side of things, whereby I'll come up with solutions whereby you'd be able to just see what you can tweak on your trading so they can be able to just go from not making money to making money, because it's very much possible. I experienced it. I went from literally not making money blinking accounts to now making money consistently in the Forex market, which is amazing. So your boy Lisiba Mutupi, please do subscribe if you haven't. You can also hit the like button, which is gonna help out a lot, like, for other people out there to be able to see, recognize that I post a lot of content speaking most importantly about Forex trading, entrepreneurship. And at the same time, please do make sure to comment below what you think, or whatever that you have in mind that you'd like to ask questions on me about, then we'll be able to just dive a bit into that. So let us dive onto today's topic. So just to break down things a bit, we're going to actually be diving onto the problems that we do have and also the solutions. And at the end, we're actually going to be walking together, like holding hands on this journey, whereby I'll be coming up with a way forward for us to be able to just go into the negative side of things and being in the positive side of things. So let us speak with the first problem that people don't get to make money in the Forex market. So the first thing is they are actually trapped in the cycle of doom. The cycle of doom, to be specific, is when you are, let's say you get a strategy, and then after getting a strategy, it starts to make you profits, you know, let's say a month, even a few days, a month, 2 months, you make profits, it's good for you, it's good, you're consistent. And then after that, you start to experience losses. So when you get to that phase where you experience losses, you haven't backtested that strategy. So when you get to that phase, what happens? What comes to your mind? You start to think of, this strategy isn't working. Or maybe this strategy works only in a specific market, like let's say in an upward market or in a downward market. Or you might start to think that maybe the strategy works when the market is only ranging, only to find out that no, that strategy works perfectly. It works perfectly for you even. But the fact, the reason being of you experiencing losses is that it's now experiencing a drawdown. You know, all strategies go through a phase whereby they get to experience a drawdown. Basically, what a drawdown is like a phase whereby that strategy that you're trading gets to be in a loss for a specific period of time, actually a longer period of time than anticipated. Meaning that out of 10 trades, maybe during a drawdown, you'd have like 6 or 7 trades that are going against you. Doesn't mean that your strategy is incorrect or you're losing money and all those things. It's just that it could either be market conditions, it could either be, let's say, I don't know, something that you need to just tweak a bit. Or it could either be like it's always something minor. It's always that 1% tweak. Remember, for me to be consistent, I only done 1% tweaks. Not, I didn't change my strategy. No, I only done 1% tweaks. And then from there, I was able to just evolve. So basically, with the cycle of doom, people get trapped into this. And then from there, they start to think that, okay, now, instead of changing this thing 1%, let's say instead of just tweaking this, what they do is that they look for more strategies out there. So they get another strategy. After getting another, let's say now they had like a market structure strategy, the next thing that they go for maybe could be indicators. They get the specific indicator, starts to make them money for that specific period of time. Then after like 1 month or 2 months again, it goes through a drawdown. What happens? This person isn't experienced. So what happens is that they instead of just playing around, like seeing what's going wrong and all those things, they see themselves not making money and they want to make money. So they get fed up and then they want the other strategy that's gonna make money. And obviously to see these strategies, they maybe search on YouTube or they just go on Instagram, like social media, to see what others are trading. And if they see others making money from their strategy, they want to also jump into that instead of just focusing on one thing and then mastering one thing. Just take a look at it, né? Even with school or whatever work, basically, like if let's say you're in school and then you've got a subject, if you go, you pass the first quarter, the second quarter, and the third quarter, like when you get to it, you see yourself getting difficult. You see the quarter getting difficult and you can't really move forward with that. Instead of jumping to the next subject, you should instead focus on that, get through the obstacles, study it, focus much more on it. So at the end of the year, you master one thing instead of just jumping from one subject to the other, That way you'll never be better at something, because you'd know the fundamentals, the basics of things. And then when you're about to master, then you're like, okay, no, it's killing me here. Let me move on to something. So that's something that we don't want. Please make sure that you don't get involved in the circle of doom. But the solution that I can help you with, like to be able to just avoid the circle of doom before getting into it, or if you're already in it, it's okay, don't worry about it. If you are already in the circle of doom, one thing that I can help you with is that backtest. You need to backtest. Like backtesting helps you out a lot. What backtesting helps you out with is the confidence. You know, it gives you confidence within the markets. Like, you know, when I take trades, when I'm experiencing losses or whatever, I'm confident. You know, you won't see me stressed out, like thinking, how am I going to pay the bills? How am I going to take care of this? No, I won't be stressed because I know in the long term, in the long run, I'm profitable. In the long run, I'm going to be making money still, no matter even though I'm experiencing losses for this week, even next week, or maybe let's say 6 trades in a row. I understand that because I backtested, that I know that in the long run you are consistent. So you need to backtest, know for sure that okay, this pay and in this specific period of time I'll be consistent, and then after maybe during this month, because normally like to experience drawdowns it could be during months. So when you backtest, you know that April, May, June, that time doesn't work out really well for you, you are most likely to go in the drawdown. So you already expected that what's coming your way, so you need to backtest. That's the first solution to the problem that we have of the cycle of doom on how to actually avoid it. So let us move into the second one and see how we can tackle this problem. But hey, like for those that like maybe you haven't seen the backtest video that I do have, you can just go back on my YouTube videos, my channel, you'll be able to see I dropped a video there where I spoke of backtesting and how to use the body play button. You'll be able to just see that and it's gonna help you out. But let us move on to the second one. The second one is that brokers get to offer you like these huge bonuses, like, you know, without even having to put money down, you get bonuses or you get all these credits and all these things. But and at the same time, if you take a look at it, and also with the leverage, I wanted to mention like the brokers offering bonuses and also with the leverage side of things. Brokers can give you like huge leverage, like 1:2,000, 1:unlimited, 1:1,000, and all those things. Basically, what you should do is that you shouldn't trade with money that you don't have. It's amazing to see that someone borrowed you money so you can place trades, but at the same time, that's money that you're risking that you don't have. So you need to actually be specific with how much you're going to be trading. So let's say, for instance, you have 2,000 rands, 2,000 or $2,000. Let's say $1,000, just to be specific, $1,000. And out the $1,000, let's say you get 50% or 100% of what you just deposited in your equity. So when you deposit $1,000, your equity is going to be $2,000. So basically what you think, or even the leverage plays a part, because then let's say the leverage is like 1:1,000, 1:800. Whereby if you take trades, you can be able to place trades that are bigger than your account. It's amazing. You can be able to place trades that are bigger than your account. But the problem is that also the risks come with that. So basically, if you're looking at the rewards only, remember that you do take risk. You remember that there's always like a win and a lose in the markets. So make sure that like the win that you're experiencing is much greater than the loss. So back to the point that I was speaking about, whereby I'm saying that like you have 1,000 rands and your equity is now 2,000 rands. So when you place trades, and now let's say when you're floating with a negative 500, your equity is going to be like what? It's going to be an amount like negative. It's going to be 1,000. No, it's not going to be negative. It's going to be 1,500. Ne? But your balance is how much? It's 1,000. So basically, the negative 500 rand is playing on your balance too. Because like now, if you're looking at it, you're losing 50% of how much you put in the trading account, which is actually not a good method of trading. So you also need to be able to just not get attracted with these brokers that offer you these crazy bonuses or these just crazy leverage, because at the same time you're trading with money that you don't have, and we don't want that in the markets. We want to actually be able to help you take that small, or even if it's like major or whatever, that account that you have, the money that you have, and grow it bit by bit. That way you'll be able to just experience consistency and you won't be risking money that you don't have, you know, because risking money that you don't have, at the end you're going to be in credit. So something we're trying to avoid here. And at the same time, you need to be with the broker that doesn't want to see you lose, because there's two types of brokers. There's ones that want to see you lose and there's ones that don't want to see you lose. Basically, the ones that want to see you lose are the ones that just offer you these things that are going to attract you. Sorry about that. That are going to attract you in the market. And whether you're beginning or what, they're going to give you all these things that seem like it's you're going to be rich very quick, né? And you don't even need to put money down. But at the same time, these people know that within 90 days, you know the 90-90 rule, within 90 days, you're going to be losing all that money. And even if, let's say, you take that small account and you grow it a bit into a bigger amount, at the end of the day, for you to withdraw, you're going to need to deposit some money. So after depositing that money, at the end of the day, what happens is that like you're going to want to, obviously, because you saw yourself taking a small account, growing it, and now you have a bigger equity, so you're gonna want to grow it much more better than the previous one. that way you're going to result to doing what? To losing money, because you don't have the experience yet. You don't have the knowledge yet. So one thing that you do is that be with a broker that instead doesn't offer you all these things that look too nice to just run to. But at the same time, it gives you everything that you need to make money from the Forex market. And most importantly, this broker makes money from commissions. So basically, making money from commissions is like when a broker wants to see you win. So they want to see you win, they want to see you make profit, because whenever you win, whenever you make profits is when they also get to get that card. So it's much better this way. And you can get that. I'll try to just put the link down in the description box of the broker that I use, because they also take commissions. And I don't get to worry about all these spreads and all these things that all those things are actually fixed. So it's much better this way. Like, just when you make profit, when you make, they take their commissions. And even when you get to experience losses, they take their commissions, they take their small fee, on which if you're in the markets with them for a long term, they get to make money, you get to make money, because you are in there for a long term. Like, let's say I've been trading for 3 years. If I have an account for like 3 years and I keep on placing trades all those 3 years, that means I'm making money. It means that they don't blow my account for 3 years. And it means also them on their side, they're making money because they're taking fees from me. But brokers that actually don't want to see you move forward are the ones that, like, let's say you be in the market for like 2-3 months, then you're out. You know what I'm saying? So we don't want that. We need to be with the positive side of things. That's the second one. Okay, now moving on the third one, and thank God I've got my notes with me. So this is actually where I want us to come up with solutions, come up with ways forward, because it's good to know what's killing us, but it's not good to know it's actually difficult to find out how we can get help. And when you get help, you shouldn't just sit down, be like, but you should actually put work into this. Like, you should implement the strategies that you get, because remember, most people don't make money trading Forex. But now I want us to actually come up with a way in, like, most people can get to make money trading Forex. You know, it's much better, you know, it's nice. I experience it, and like it's I just want people to be making money trading Forex. So you need to actually come up with a plan. This is a method that I want us to come up with a plan. So this plan is going to actually help you come up with a defined plan on whereby, on how you're actually going to be making money during trading. Because, like, if you look at it, I traded both the side of not having a plan, just jumping into the markets, doing my own thing, and I traded the side of having a plan, having a detailed plan. Doesn't have to be like too perfect, but having a detailed plan whereby it showed me that if I just focus on 1, 2, 3, I can be able to get the types of results that I want. So this is the plan that we are actually going to be focusing on now. So with this plan, I want us to break the year into 4 quarters, man, because remember we spoke of 2020. I want us to break the year into 4 quarters. So in this 4 quarter, we've got the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, obviously, man. So on the 1st quarter, I want you to actually focus on learning and observing. So basically what learning and observing could be is like you just get to have a lot of materials. Like, you get to download a lot of videos, get to watch a lot of, you get to just read a lot of books. Use this time to just learn and observe what others are doing out there. Observe why this one is making money and why this one is not making money. See what's working and what's not, just by observing, né? And by learning the right things, learning the knowledge, having the knowledge. Yet you don't have the experience, but you're having the knowledge, né? So now that's the first quarter, actually focusing a bit more on that, on the learning and observing. And then on the second quarter, I actually want you to focus on experiencing, like having a trading account. Like, let's say now what you're gonna do is that you're gonna fund a trading account. Doesn't have to be a lot of money. It can be $100, $50, $200, whatever money that you're willing to learn with, because you're learning, you're still on a learning phase. Whatever money that you're willing to learn with, focus a bit on the experience side of things. And once you get on the experience side of things, what you also do is that you are funding your account. So basically, when you fund your account, is that, let's say the second quarter starts, it's like 3 months in a quarter, and so when the second quarter starts, you funded, let's say $100, and now that you learned and you have some information and, you know, you observed what's working and what's not, what you do is that on the second quarter, the first month, let's say you funded $100, and now you're moving forward, you see yourself moving forward. And what you do is that the second month, what you can do is that you can also fund maybe $50 or $100, and that way you're making let's say you made profits, you funded $100, you made $30 profit. Doesn't have to be a lot, $30 profits, then, and now you fund your account again with $100, and with that $100, now your equity, your balance is like $230, which is better. And what you do is that now, instead of making $30, let's say you make $70, so your account is on $300, and the third month, what you do is that you find another $100. So basically where you add now is that you're actually on $400. So you grew your account, you grew your equity, and you're seeing that you're profitable within the market. It's much better this way. And trust me, like, this method, one thing that I'll say is that it can work, like, before even like getting on the second quarter, you can start to make money and all those things. But I'm trying to give you a much more detailed plan, something that, let's say, if I started out trading years ago, I'd follow this method, because I know I started making money when I told myself that I'm gonna learn and I'm gonna see what I'm gonna experience. Like, I won't want to make money now. I'm gonna learn and experience. So that's when I started to make money. And then now jumping onto the third quarter. On the third quarter, what you do is that you keep on just funding your account. Let's say now you're up, you're on $400 now. You keep on funding your account with, let's say, $50 or $100. And at the same time, now what you do is that you are coming up with rules. Remember, on the second quarter, what you've done is that you're experiencing. Now you are coming up with rules. You're seeing what's working for you and what's not working for you. Because remember, on the first quarter, you were seeing what's working for others and what's not. So you knew what to go for. But now you're actually looking at what's working for you and what's not working for you. What's making you take a lot of losses and what's actually making you profits. So you focus more a bit onto that. That is the third quarter, and you also keep on funding your account. Let's say now obviously you are getting better because you've been learning, you've been experiencing, you are getting better. So your account is growing now. Every month you get to make $200 profits, and $200, so 3 months is like $600, you're on $400, so that's $1,000, and you kept on funding 100 rands for those 3 months. That's like 1,300 rands. I was speaking of dollars because you're funding dollars. That's $1,300. That's a lot of progress. You know, a lot of people dream of that. You know, when I was starting out trading, like I dreamt of having like $1,000 account, things like that. So that's now you have a detail plan. You see yourself making this. And on the fourth quarter, this is where you start to nail things down. So now on the fourth quarter, what you do is that you are gonna be like refining your trades. You are gonna be checking your performance, like refining those trades, like whatever the tweaks that you need to make. Remember, we spoke of the cycle of doing the tweaks and all these things. You'd be refining it, just looking at what actually makes you profit more, what actually makes you get big profits, what actually makes you take these losses. So you're gonna be looking a bit more detailed into that, because you'd be also having done a journal where you take down your trades. And you'd be looking at your performance, like seeing if you are really profitable within the markets, if you are really consistent in the markets, if you are not. And you just focus a bit more on that on the fourth quarter. And after that, I promise, like the next year, 2021, you'd be, because like, look at it like this, like when you end the year, you're going to end the year with, like with the trading account, let's say it could even be $2,000, where you just started with $100, could now be on $2,000. And when you get to next year, now you have capital that you're gonna start up with knowledge, with experience, with all these things that you actually need to be profitable. So that's a killer for me. For me, like if I started trading now, I'd perfectly follow this method, because this is actually why like a lot of people make money in the Forex market. Like people don't make money when they actually like jump into it to make money. Like if you just jump into something, if you're chasing money, money's not gonna come. But if you just focus on learning, refining, focusing, mastering your craft, all these things, becoming a better person, that's when the money is gonna come to you. Like money follows that, or those that are actually better. Like the better you are, the more money you get. Like whatever profession, whatever that you do, whatever, even if you have a website, like the better that your website is, the better like money you're gonna be making from that website. You understand? So even the better you are, the better your mindset is, the better your trading is, the more money you're gonna be making. Because even like I was like, when I started, like when I was still asking myself how I can be profitable, I was like just wanting to make a lot of money in like quick, just wanted to hold a lot of money, do all these things. But at the same time, I noticed that, okay, no, when I told myself that I want to go back to the drawing board, I want to see what I'm doing wrong and what I'm doing right, and I want to use small lots so I can learn, I noticed that that's when I was actually making profits like this. I was making slow, bit by bit profits. But when I was telling myself I want to make money now, that's when I would lose my account, or I'd lose 50% of my account, and all those things. So this is actually me breaking it down for you. 2020, I want you to actually make money from trading Forex. This is actually going to be the year for you to actually experience a breakthrough. At the same time, I've got a free training that if you want, I'll just put the link below. Free training, I've got like lessons that I put down together, whereby you'd be able to just see, get, and like learn. I like the fact that like you're going to be breaking it down as I have given. Like the first quarter, you're going to be learning, observing. Second quarter, you're going to be funding, experiencing. Third quarter, you're going to be funding, still refining and developing rules. And then the fourth quarter, you're going to be defining and checking your performance. Then you'd be killing like this. But it's a boy, Lisa Motipia. Thank you so much for watching my YouTube video. It means a lot that you actually watched up until this very end. Make sure you check out my free training that I do have for you, and I'll always be here to help you and assist you. Please do make sure to hit the subscribe button if you haven't, and at the same time hit the like if this video actually helped you out a lot. Because if it helps you out a lot and you hit the like, it's gonna reach more people and it's gonna help out more people. So bye, this is Motipia, and I thank you so much for watching up until this end.